It is the most typical dish of my home region, Friuli Venezia Giulia. It has only 3 ingredients, and I made it in the semi-final of MasterChef. You guessed it right, it is Frico, and this is...
Dinner with Luca, Tiny Home Edition!
Frico was originated in Friuli Venezia Giulia, northeast of Italy. You see, at the north we have the Alps, at south is the Adriatic Sea, very close to Venice. A beautiful hidden gem in Italy. Next time you go to Europe, go and visit Friuli and taste some delicious Frico. The legend of Frico tells that it was an old housewife. She had to make dinner for the family. She opened the pantry and she only had cheese, potatoes and onions. And she put them all together and she invented something amazing. It's the history of my people. It's such a delicious dish. And I'm going to show you how to make it.
Let's get the ingredients ready. Onions, very thin slice. Then I take my cheese and I cut it in cubes. The smaller the cubes, the faster it will melt. And then the potato will peel just before we start cooking. A knob of butter. You can use olive oil if you like. You can use any other kind of fat actually. I think that back in the day, most likely they were using lard or maybe another animal fat. Let the onions go right away, because they will take a little bit of time. While the onions are cooking, let's talk about the most important question that I get asked. What type of cheese should I use? In Italy, in Friuli, we use Montaggio cheese because it's local made over there. And I understand if any other parts of the world, it's hard to find Montaggio. Here in America, I easy find Asiago or Piave, but any medium hard cheese actually works. So don't use any soft cheese, no cream cheeses, nothing smoked or nothing with too much pepper maybe and too much extra flavor. 6 months, 4 months works very well. And I also use a hard cheese like a Parmesan cheese, grated and just added to the mix. You can either cook the onions nice and slowly, or to make your life a little bit easier and faster, add a little bit of water. Now it's time to add the potato. Take a cheese grater with the large holes and grate all inside. And now remember the trick of the 2 spoons. They will help you to mix everything together. What's happening now is that the potatoes are cooking and releasing all the starch, and it will make kind of a paste with your onions. It's a dish that takes some time, but it's very easy and it tastes delicious. Now it's time for the star of the dish, our magnificent cheese. And now just put the cheese on here and let the cheese make his magic. And then I'll end up with a handful of grated cheese. Now, again, the 2 spoons, obviously. Mix it a little bit, but then let the cheese do his job. What's going to happen right now is that the cheese with separate, basically. The solid will go with your onions and potatoes, and then the oil and the fat of the cheese will be the base of the Frico. Basically, you are frying the Frico in its own fat. It sounds amazing. I know it doesn't sound very healthy, but you can start the diet tomorrow. Don't worry about it. Mix it up and mix it up. Now is the time to give probably your last mix. Please remember, use a non-stick pan. Back in the day, they used to make it with iron pots. I have no idea how they did it, God bless them, but now we're a little bit luckier, we have non-stick pan. Makes your life much easier. Mix everything and just let it sit there. This is the time where you want the oil to bubble and make a nice crust with the cheese. You can see that if you check the sides,
you'll see a little bit of a crust forming. There's a different color in the bottom. Then you can do a couple of things. You can move it like this and help yourself with the spoon. You see it's going to start to move more and more and more. Now it's ready to flip. Be careful, because this is the most important part of the Freecon. If you mess this up, then you need to start all over again. But it's okay. Watch carefully. Take a lid, slide it on, pot on top, turn. Et voila! Now let's make the crust in the bottom part. Just a few more minutes and we are ready. I like to serve this on a cutting board. Just like that, you put it down. Do not cut into it right away. You need to let the cheese to form up and get strong again. If you cut it now, it will be all a floppy mess. I know it smells delicious and you wanna get into it right away. Just be patient. You did an amazing job. It looks amazing. Please share this recipe. It gets me so excited when I see you guys making my dishes. The recipe will be in dinnerwithluca.com. You can find the videos on YouTube, Instagram, and Facebook. I love you guys. Let's make Freecon all together. Ciao, buon appetito, ci vediamo presto.